Hello guys and welcome back at Mastercam. Let's see and Y axis toolbar. Mastercam, in this video we will discuss about that how we can prepare that one part by the help of lathe toolpaths. In the Mastercam last video we will prepare model for that one component. The drawing is as you can see on the display. And in this video we will discuss about that before creating of C axis and Y axis toolpath for the whole and contour area, we will prepare that one part by the help of lathe toolpaths. So in this video we will discuss about that the three operations. First number is the facing operation, second one operation is roughing operation. In the roughing operation we will prepare and make operation for the deep cutting, so that one some tricks will be there. And also for the grooving operation, when preparing a grooving operation, in the grooving operation there is only still that one material we have to remove. So what is the trick I am going to use, I also show you. So let's start that how we can prepare that one part by the help of a solid model. So first I remove all the operations, so delete. So I delete all the unnecessary operation by the help of delete all. Now I have a single solid body or a solid workpiece. First I have to choose view and remain axis and all these necessary points. Now preparing the operation for the tool paths, I need only a part which only for the chain selection option. So preparing that one part we have to select tool paths and going in the turning. First we have to prepare stock model. So going in the tool setting, input program number, assigns warm up duplicate tool number, stock size, properties, make form 2 points, 1 point and second 1 point. As you know what the diameter of that workpiece, we can select from the here also. We select the diameter value and now use margin. The back side 30 mm, front area 2 mm and diameter is also 2 mm of margin. Now we have to select chuck and the jaw. For the selecting jaw, select parameters from stock maximum and that input the what is the grip length and now press OK. So this is the necessary parameters which we have to provide in each and every single operation. If you want to download the drawing as well as the model, the both our link is still available in the description, you can download. Now the first one operation we have to prepare for the facing operation. If you want to know about the detail, read about the facing operation. So we are also providing a video on the facing operation, you can check it out. So I have to select tool, input feed value, spindle speed minimum, maximum, and I have to input the just a comment face. And now I have to provide reference point. Okay and okay. Now I have to choose face parameters. What is the depth of cut? Here I am inputting depth of cut value, overcut amount, retract amount, all these necessary parameters I just provide as per requirement. And now I press okay. So as you can see, we are preparing the face toolpaths. Now the next one operation is the for the roughing operation. So again I have to choose turning and now rough. In the roughing operation I am also make a semi finish operation. So I have select first chain then the last chain. Okay. Now I have to choose the tool again. What is the feed rate? Finish feed rate, spindle speed minimum and the maximum spindle speed. And now I have to input the comment as per operation. Now I have to select the reference point. Okay. For the roughing parameter, if you want to read and want to learn deep about the roughing, what is the all these parameter, so you can check it out, video I have already prepared. So what is the depth of cut value, stock to leave on wall, stock to leave on Z entry amount should be 1 mm, and here use stock for outer boundary. Now I have to prepare that one program. So that program is like as a simple turning operation, but we have to remove that one material from the also from the here and also from the extend from the entity. So the in the final path we have to remove that one part by the help of cutoff. So for that one we have to again select parameters, going in the semi finish. When we are selecting a semi finish parameter, it is also make a tool path cut like as a finish. So I have to input the depth cut value, and after semi finish what is the stock value for the X and Z, I am input the value is 00. The next one step I have to choose lead in and lead out. In the lead in I have to choose like that one, the entry amount should be in that form. So and the lead out I have to extend the value, or the total value is 4 mm. So due to the extend value, toolpath will be automatically extend 4 mm. Now for the deep cutting and regenerate. So as you can see, the toolpath is extend for that one, the total from the total length. Now I have to remove that one area for the deep cutting. For deep cutting, I have to select parameters, and I have to choose plunge parameter. When we are selecting a plunge parameter, we have to select second one option. When we are selecting second one operation, that as you can see in the drawing, it will be automatically make a dip in the diameter as well as the face. Okay. And again, I have to regenerate the program. So as you can see, the program is automatically still completed, and the all material which that tool can be removed, the whole material is removed. Now the next one operation I have to prepare, that one is known as grooving operation, and in the grooving operation I have to remove only that one material. So for the removing that one material, I have to choose turning groove, choose chain selection method. Now select chain from here to here. Okay. After selecting the chain, I have to choose tool. I can choose any kind of tool. I choose a tool, that one is like that. So I have to choose tool. After choosing the tool, I have to edit some parameters. What is the D value? D value is 3 mm. D means what is the value for the insert thickness, and the C value, what is the tool nose radius. Both value are important for that one parameter or operation. Now okay, so tool is ready for the program. Now I have to select feed rate, finish feed rate, spindle speed, finish spindle speed, and the maximum spindle speed, and I have to input the value groove. I now select the reference point by the help of a same method as we selecting on last few operations. Now in the grooving operation, there is a simple trick. Let me show you. First we are preparing as a simple operation. I have to groove shape parameter, use stock for outer boundary. In the groove rough parameter, I have to select groove wall smooth, all necessary parameters as well as the last point. Now I have to select groove finish parameter. What is the overlap between passes? 3 mm. Ignore overcut amount, and now I have to select lead in and lead out. In a lead in and lead out, I have to select tangent, and also in a lead out, tangent. When I am now creating OK, so that time there is some issues are here, as you can see. For creating an operation like that, that we have to remove that one material, we have to choose a simple trick method. So what is the trick? We have to again select parameter. In a parameter, we have to go at the groove shape parameter. In a groove shape parameter, there are two options at here available. On these, choose stop end of contour, extend, shorten, and the distance is approximately 10 mm. okay, and regenerate. When I just make regenerate for that one program, it will be automatically regenerating for that one path. So we have to make also remove that one area, because that one is still also in a large size. So again I have to select parameters and reduce the length from, increase length from 10 to 15 mm. Okay, and regenerate.